Let me start by saying I'm a musician. And in fact, on greeting people, every day when I meet people, they say, you're a musician, oh great, and what else do you do for a living? Yes, it's true that I do get that response constantly. It's all began with my childhood, and I truly believe we are shaped by our environment. For me, at age three, what I could hear when I went to sleep or when I woke up is the sound of dadak dadak, dadak dadak, dadak dadak, dadak dadak, dadak dadak. Well, can you guess what that was? Yes, it was the heartbeat of the passing trains over the Bandestration platforms, which is a tiny little suburb in Mumbai. And across the railway tracks were many mosques, and I could hear the faint call of the azan. And that was sheer music for me. And this is where I grew up, a tiny 300 square foot apartment close to the railway tracks, which housed six members of a family, a Goan family. And as they say, if you threw a stone on a Goan household, it's going to land on a guitar, on a violin or a trumpet or a saxophone. And true, so mine landed on a little piano, and Dad was a musician, and he would keep on playing, and I would correct him, and I'd say, Dad, I think you need to change this, you know, because I found some creative disruption kind of in a positive way in the way I was thinking at age five. And so he decided to take it positively and send me to formal training in classical music. And that's when my journey began as an eight-year-old little girl. And my first teacher, Mrs. Blanche Vegas, the first thing she told me is, I know you've come here to study music, but nevertheless, these lessons are going to take you through life, whether it's finance, it's music, it's technology, it's business, whatever. There are three things in life. It may be an oral phenomenon, but truly, it is melody, which is emotion, the theme that carries you through. Very, very important. The melody of the song, the melody and the theme of anything that you design. Next, she said, you need rhythm. It's physiological. You need it for your system. You need it. It's like the beating of your heart or the blood pumping through your veins or a little drop of water from a leaking tap. All that is rhythm. She says, it's important to take note of it. And last but not least, harmony. Well, it's so required in today's world to blur the issues of conflict that we are facing. And harmony, truly, truly important. And that's what I learned from my first classical composer, J.S. Bach. And J.S. Bach dictates, you know, it's important to have four-part harmony, which is the bass, the tenor, the alto, and the soprano. When you put it all together, you get harmony, truly. In one of our spiritual books, you know, they say, your left hand should never know what your right hand is doing, but not so in music. You need to do that. So I'm going to demonstrate a little piece that I learned as an eight-year-old, my first ever performance on All India Radio. Moving on to, yes, being a teenager, musical paralysis. Well, I was deeply rooted and stopped in my tracks when I was exposed and exploring the situations that afforded me to get influenced by music, by sounds, by people, by textures. And as TEDx rightly said at the start of the speech, he says, you know, TEDx is all about bubbling ideas in your community. And what better way to start? Community. I came from this little suburb where we were encouraged to play in church, give back to the community, play in the church, and I would play at church, and people would come up and say, you know, We didn't listen to the word the priest was saying, but when you played, it kind of touched us. So for me, that was an award, you know, to even touch someone's life with one note of music that I played. And thanks to that, we were constantly sharing, composing. In fact, by age 18, I composed my first musical. And by 19, my next original musical. And believe it or not, community, well, another famous actor, Salman Khan, was in my neighborhood. And he was on stage with me, dancing, in fact. And I think for once, he had to face the music, right? So there he was, along with me, giving back to the community. And definitely, as I said, after community came discovery. And with discovery came the Walkman. I was gifted the Walkman. And with the headphones, all I heard was orchestrations and strings and timpanis and tablas and sitars. And I said, oh my God, this is truly amazing. This is an invention. And I want it all. I want to play the synthesizer, not just the piano. And so began my journey when I started learning all the classical greats. I learned the romance of Beethoven and Chopin, the war and peace and angst and revolution of Rachmaninoff, and of course, the intricacies and the mathematics of Bach and Bartok. So armed with all of this knowledge, I decided I'm going to get and start producing music. So, well, a little bit of adversity set in, and I approached a couple of senior musicians, and I said, you know what, I need to buy a synthesizer. I saw you performing, and I need to play. So they gave me a once-over and said, can you afford it? And number two, you really want to enter into a woman's world? Well, that was silly, of course. And I took it with a pinch of salt, and I never stopped. And I started performing and performing. And I joined the band at age 14 because mom passed away at a very young age. My dad passed away at a really, really young age. And so to supplement her earnings, I started playing in a band at age 14. And as you can see, I was clearly influenced by Beethoven. And we called the band Beethovens. Okay, so, well, that was cute. So I blessed my adversity. And so began my journey as a teenager. And moving on to adulthood. Well, before I move on to adulthood, I'd like to play a little piece. I'm sure you've heard this when the water filter is running or your car is backing. You've heard this little tune. Can you guess which tune it is? Can you sing it for me? Okay, this one's called For Elise, Few Release.
So I decided to put a spin on it and give it a little Dixieland feel to it. So.
That was Few Release with a Dixieland New Orleans twist. Well, my journey went on to adulthood, and that was the trip of my life, truly the trip of my life, because by then I had got my gizmos and I started teaching myself the computers. Well, I had a little son growing up, but I used the time when he was at school to study the innovation and invention of computers. And I started doing music for theater, albums, advertising, films. With theater came a wonderful opportunity to work with Nasiruddin Shah and Vikram Kapadia, and they told me, change your sound, change your music, be creatively disruptive. And so I used the funeral march of Chopin along with Taufik Qureshi's duff and tablas and created a sound which was Mark Anthony and Brutus together at war. So things like that were crucial for my experimentation. Then came Blood Brothers, came Jesus Christ Superstar, Broken Images, the Mahatma, and all of that, using all my information that I'd studied as a child and as a teenager. Of course, advertising, albums, Banungi Mehemis India, Indiva, Mantra, all of that came pouring forth. The age of Channel V and MTV also gave me a chance to produce, compose, and arrange. I'd like to talk about film. Well, you can never take the Bollywood out of a person out of Mumbai, right? And I was involved in a big blockbuster film as a composer, arranger, and performer. And I'd like to show you how three notes of music can truly become a hit. Just three notes of music, all right? So you have to sing with me, and I want you to guess which song it is, which tune it is. La, 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 can you sing with me? La, 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 come on, Dana. La, 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 can you sing it faster? La, 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 which song? Come on. La, 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 la. Dona, Kethon, yes, you are my Sonia. So just three notes of music. So well, that was one of my parts of my journey, my musical journey, Kabhi Kushi, Kabhi Gam, yes. And yes, that was the film part of it. And let's move on to, yes, this was just recent. As a six-year-old, like I said earlier, we are shaped by our environment. And as a six-year-old child, I would sit in this tiny little house with a black and white television set, and I would listen to Kaifi Azmi with shairi and poetry. And my mom would say, what are you doing? Do you understand this language? And I would say, yes, I do. It sounds like music to my ears. Little knowing, years later, I would be at this exalted wonder of the world with a chance to put poetry to reading to the soulful seeker. Yes, with the Bollywood personality spouting poetry and me adding and underscoring music at the wonderful monument. And well, soon after that, came the now. Well, the now. I truly believe that the learning never stops, it always starts. And what better way than in your home itself? My young son, who's also a musician, well, I'm constantly learning from him, whether it's music or it's just simple philosophy. We constantly learn from our environment and from the people who matter. And I decided to go back to study, and I went to Berkeley last year, and I walked through the hallowed halls of this wonderful institution, learning from young musical geniuses, Grammy Award-winning musicians, music with music therapy, with neurosurgery disorders, how to stimulate responses within them. So I came back armed with this knowledge, and I decided, yes, I have to collaborate. And very soon, I've met this wonderful lady, Dhanashree Pandit Rai, and together we've been trying to demystify world music. You know, mix the blue scale with Madhukaun's Rag Bhairavi, Rag Jog, Rag Todi. So we are on the path of experimentation, and very soon we hope to give you our brand of music, very, very soon. And yes, before that, I'd like to say, when I went to Berkeley, there was one thing that hit me. I went with full bravado that I know it all, I've done it all. But actually, when I went there, I thought it was to reinforce what I know, but actually it was quickly to uncover what I don't. So that's what learning did to me. And now, right now, recently, the last thing that I'm doing is sonic branding, another collaborative effort with brand music. And my credo is, if the whole world were blind, what would your product sound like? All you need is your earring, right? It's like a Mogoscape, which says, ding, ding, ding. You automatically know it is Britannia, right? Pum, 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 pum. Well, that is Inter and Tel. So we decided to create our own Mogoscape, and I was fortunate enough to do a couple of airlines, banking, realty, and food products. But the recent one, I'm sure you're all going to hear it. It's a reputed bank. And whenever you withdraw your money from your ATM, this is what you're going to hear. And the brief that I was given was, ever evolving, ever changing, never stopping. And yet the ting, 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 ting had to be there. You know, similarly, like I was given another brief, another confusing brief, which was when
Mr. Modi just came down, and I had to compose a song for Make in India. The brief was Nusrat Fateh Ali meets Peter Gabriel. Oh my God, how do I accomplish that one? Well, all the influences that came within me helped me create this. And this is the one that you're going to hear when you go to your ATM next. That's the tune that you're going to hear from your ATMs very soon, very shortly. Yes, and I'd like to end my little talk by saying, I would love to stay motivated by my dreams and still ruled by my fears, never taking myself seriously and always exploring the unknown. For me, is penetrating the darkness, truly. And that's what I wish my journey and my musical yatra will continue imbibing, shaping me by my environment and my influences. So I'd like to end by giving you a little snippet of how the classical maestros, they're reborn and reborn again and again within Bollywood, within us, and here goes. Mozart ki kahani. What happened when Mozart meets Bollywood and me? Well, this is what you're going to hear.